Namaste, mera naam Dhaval Desai hai and I'm very happy today ki aaj dopahar mein on a very very short notice kyunki kal hi hame pata chala वैसे ये जो फंक्शन था वो हम लोग कल करने वाले थे पी नॉर्थ वार्ड ऑफिस में, लेकिन फिर कुछ पता चला कि मैडम नहीं आ पाएंगी वहाँ पे, उनको कुछ मंत्रालय में मीटिंग आ पड़ी. एंड शी वी आर वेरी ग्रेटफुल टू हर कि हमारी जो रिक्वेस्ट थी सीमा मैडम ने की उनको कि वो आज हमारी ऑफिस में आके ये बुक रिलीज़ करे, और उन्होंने तुरंत उसको स्वीकारा. तो मैडम थैंक यू वेरी मच. और मैं अपनी तरफ से कहूँगा कि आई रिप्रेजेंट अ थिंक टैंक, और एक थिंक टैंक का जो काम होता है कि टू बिकम द एजेंट ऑफ चेंज फॉर द गवर्नमेंट एंड परहैप्स कम अप विथ सम वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट और वेरी इन डेप्थ रिसर्च, कि हम लोग कुछ ऐसे सुझाव लाएं कि जो लोगों में कि जो लोगों के लिए जो पॉलिसीज बनी हैं वो और सरलता से इम्प्लीमेंट की जाए, और जो फ़ायदा जो एक सोच जो बनती है कि ऐसा फ़ायदा मिलेगा वो सही में लोगों तक पहुँचे. और इसीलिए जो हमारी ये पुस्तिका है, I think it will play a very important role in fulfilling a very critical component of the Swachh Bharat mission. कि जहाँ तक हम लोग solid waste management और sanitation और water supply सब मिला हुआ है, housing policies अगर उसको फैलाएँ तो कितना भी फैल सकता है, तो उसमें एक open defecation बंद करने के लिए आज मुंबई में क्या क्या किया जा सकता है. तो आज तक जो generally जो BMC में एक सोच थी, when it came to individual toilets people just used to say not possible, बहुत कंजेशन है, लाइन कहाँ डालेंगे, सीवरेज डिस्पोजल कहाँ करेंगे. लेकिन अगर मन बना लिया जाए तो टेक्नोलॉजी की मदद से, और जनरली सिर्फ एक लोग एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन और पॉलिटिशियंस वो तीनों साथ मिल करके ऐसे इंडिविजुअल टॉयलेट्स हर घर में, हर घर में एक शौचालय, वो सपना साकार कर सकते हैं. सो इनफैक्ट इवन बिफोर वी एस्टैब्लिश द महात्मा गांधी सेंटर for sanitation, cleanliness and community health, under the supervision of Mr. Kulkarni we have been very actively looking at the problem of sanitation generally in Mumbai, water and sanitation both. And over the past 6 years that we have been in existence in Mumbai, we have been following it very closely, and this presentation is an amalgamation of certain findings that we have come across. And if I'm going inaccurate in any slide, then please do stop me, and so I'll either see clarification from you or you might see clarification from me. So when you talk about Swachh Bharat, ek agar Swachh Bharat ki baat karein, to pehle to main kahunga ke ek national level pe hum log socha jaye, to jo bahut hi important government ki sansthaen hain, census aur the urban development ministry, ke jiske तहत pura Swachh Bharat अभियान किया जा रहा है, तो उन दोनों में ही कुछ confusion है. कि सेंसस के कहता है कि लेस देन 31% ऑफ इंडियाज पॉपुलेशन इज़ विथ एक्सेस टू सैनिटेशन फैसिलिटीज़, मतलब इट सेज़ दैट अबाउट 70% ऑफ द पीपल डू नॉट हैव टॉयलेट्स इन और एक्सेस टू प्रॉपर टॉयलेट्स, वेयर एज द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ अर्बन डेवलपमेंट एज पर द 2011 डेटा इट सेज़ दैट 57% ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन हैज़ सैनिटेशन कवरेज. सो आई डो नॉट नो हाउ टू फिल दिस गैप, एंड आई बेग योर पार्डन बट आई वुड वॉन्ट टू अगेन like you know point out as kind of a confusion that we have come across in the BMC records, jahan pe ek survey kehta hai ki Mumbai pure shahar mein 118 jagah hai jahan pe 15,000 log jitne jo hain wo open defecation karte hain. To agar wo liya jaye to Mumbai is almost zero defecation, open defecation, it is, we are already open defecation free because it comes to less than 0.5% of the total population. So I do not know where, like you know, what to believe. In the end, as a researcher, it becomes a kind of a challenge for us. Now, if you look at the Nirmal Bharat Abhiyan, which is now history, the target was 2017, and great ambitions, like you know, to make India free from open defecation, to ensure 100% safe disposal of fecal waste. It was a very ambitious thing, no doubt, but was it achievable, or was it just a well-intentioned goal with no action plan? And as it turned out, it was a very well-intentioned goal, but with some very loose implementation, and with some very, and we are talking about a huge universe. The center ek plan banata hai, eventually wo government or local bodies ko implement karna hai. Aur agar sanyojan nahi hoga, especially when you take the case of Mumbai, when BMC is just about 20% of the land and the rest belongs to others, then how do you find that synergy and that coordination to implement that is citywide? And so we talk about the latest thing, which is currently one of the most in thing in India, the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. The target is again 2019. A lot of ambitious targets set in as the goals up to leading up to 2019. But again, the question is that it's a huge ambitious thing, but is it achievable? Or will it also be a well-intentioned goal with no specific action plan? And so these are some of the, if you go to the website of the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, तो वहाँ पे ऐसे आठ हर एक मेजर सिटीज़ के लिए वर्क्स बनाए गए हैं 2019 तक कंप्लीट होने में. तो उसके अंदर कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग है ऑफ द लोकल बॉडीज़ या जो भी उसको इंप्लीमेंट करेगा, कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ न्यू इंडिविजुअल हाउस होल्ड्स. एंड आई एम वेरी हैप्पी दैट देर आर 51,000 बाई द एंड ऑफ 15, बाई द एंड ऑफ 2019 विच हैज बीन प्लान्ड इन मुंबई. एंड इट इज़ अप टू द BMC टू मेक दिस हैपन, अदरवाइज इट्स नॉट जस्ट गोइंग टू हैपन. देर इज़ कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ कम्युनिटी टॉयलेट्स, there is construction of public toilets, there is conversion of insanitary latrines, and I'm sure they are talking about MHADA here, but the figure that they have given is only around 746 right up to 2000. Like the problem as such, I would, according to me, is MHADA, because wo banate hain without any ownership, there is no electricity, no water. So I don't know why to build an infrastructure which is going to be of disuse maybe in just the first year of its construction. Then there is conversion of pit latrines into sanitary latrines. There is a massive focus on public awareness and IEC, and also a very strong focus on solid waste management will together achieve the ambition of a clean Mumbai and a clean India eventually. And likewise, if this is for Mumbai suburban, there are the specific 8 heads for Mumbai city where the works have been planned. But when you talk when you talk about the national vision, I'm sure there is a lot of planning that has happened at the local self-government level. But when you look at the website, it has absolutely no idea of what is the kind of the total financial allocation or the requirements that this program will need to be implemented in Mumbai. So the last two columns of unit of cost per unit as per city-specific norms and the state's incentive is completely blank. So either they are not aware and the state is not aware what the BMC and how the BMC will go ahead. And similarly for both, the earlier one was for city and this is for Mumbai suburban, where you see both the last columns blank. So let us see the scenario in Mumbai. As I said, the universe is very, very vast and we are looking at something as a very complex problem. Aur jo problem badhta gaya hai because of neglect over the last 50, 60 odd years. So when you look at the money flow in the sanitation pipeline in Mumbai, we all know that the BMC budget is around 37,000 crore. Of which I would please, if I'm going wrong here, because I just took it today, it's around 6,000 crore of WSSD, which comes to around 17% of the total outlay for Mumbai, and of which around 2,000 crore is set aside for this, just the sewerage component. Now, this is very critical. If we talk about community toilets or public toilets, then today 90% of the time that we have found is that they are letting out their waste directly into the stormwater drains, and which by itself is a huge health hazard. So agar hum log sewerage connectivity nahi denge, so there is a possibility of even the one home one toilet program not achieving the full results. And of course for SSP, which is one of a great model of the BMC which started with the World Bank help, there is around 28.5 crore which has been set aside for the implementation of the SSP for this year. And there's more. When you talk about the money pipeline, there are the corporator funds. Har corporator ke paas 1 crore rupiah hai. To har 5 saal agar pura karenge, to it amounts to a kitty of over 1,135 crore. And this is where the problem really is, because I don't think that the corporators with their 1 crore will be able to make any significant difference in their constituencies. But here is where the problem arises. When we are talking about the MLA fund and the MP fund, which together constitute around 200 crore per annum. They say around 54 crore in terms of the MLA fund per year of 36 MLAs, with 1.5 crore coming to each MLA for his constituency development. And 2 crores per MP, which is around 60 crore. So that at the end of the 5-year term comes to around, say, 100 plus crore, which is where the problem really lies, because the entire MP and the MLA funds, a large chunk of it, is diverted to MHADA by the Slum Improvement Board for the construction of absolute hell holes. It's not to say that whatever is constructed by the BMC is great. Of course, there's a lot of lacunae and a lot to be done, but the real problem is MARA. And so there are also various other sources of funds which actually trickle some funds as and when necessary into the sanitation in the water department, HITI. And these are some of the examples. And so what actually is the problem in Mumbai? Now, if you look at the development and the demographic patterns in Mumbai, then not too long ago, we used to say, consider Dharavi as the largest slum in India, the most congested, M-East, M-West, what, to matlab, wahan pe to slum ke ilawa kuch bhi nahi hai. But if you look at a survey which was done by the BMC, conducted by Mr. Cybertech in 2014-15, P-North, which was supposed to be an affluent ward like Malad, is now the most, not just the most populated, but also the one having the largest number of slum dwellers. So the demographics of the city have changed, and perhaps so when it comes to implementation and the allocation of funds for WSSD and not just sanitation or solid waste management, we need to have this keep this in mind. And again, when you look at the scenario in Mumbai, if you look at the total number of residents, which is around 1.24 crore, with the total number of toilets available in the public domain, if agar community toilet block slum ki baat kar le, या फिर पब्लिक में बात कर लें और जो MCGM जो देती है जो सुविधा वो MSDP के जरिए होती है विच कंस्ट्रक्ट टॉयलेट थ्रू द स्लम सैनिटेशन प्रोजेक्ट देन देर इज SWM डिपार्टमेंट विच इज ऑल्सो इन टू टॉयलेट कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड देर आर अ फ्यू एग्जाम्पल्स वेयर द वार्ड इटसेल्फ हैज़ एलोकेटेड फंड्स फॉर टॉयलेट कंस्ट्रक्शन द रेस्ट इज MHADA प्राइवेट प्लेयर्स आर देर एंड देर आर अदर्स एंड देर इज ऑल्सो वन इंस्टेंस दैट वॉज फाउंड वेयर द रेलवेज हैड कंस्ट्रक्टेड टॉयलेट्स इन फॉर द पब्लिक. Now the point is that when you talk about sanitation of the city, railways is a very, very important component. You cannot have dirty railway stations and a clean outside. I hope we reach that, we fulfill that dream one day. But I think when the railways cannot even keep their own stations clean, it is, I think, far too much to ask them to keep the periphery clean. So of, like, if you calculate the number of people in Mumbai with the availability of toilets in the public domain, then on an average, it comes to around one toilet seat per 65 slum residents. And of this total, just 19% are constructed, owned and maintained by MCG. And the 65%, I think it's a little more than this, we are not actually sure of the exact figure, is constructed by MHADA, and it has absolutely zero ownership. And the flaws can, like, you know, you can write volumes on just the flaws of the MHADA kind of a toilet. And the rest 16% are divided among private agencies, which includes Sulab and a lot of other NGOs who have come forward in this. And to make matters worse for the BMC, there are some very funny laws like the SRA, which till very recently, till the High Court ordered, which the BMC was restricted or barred from giving any sort of a civic amenity to the so-called residents of the illegal slums, were in Mumbai before, after the cutoff date of the SRA. But that problem over the last 15 years of SRA being there in Mumbai has become so vast and so menacingly big that to today identify the eligible candidates who should be given the civic amenity itself is a big question. Aur ye court order ke bawajood agle 10-15 saal tak unko kabhi coverage milne nahi wala hai. And so when you look at Mumbai, like, there have been some very great examples of participatory community driven models tried out in Mumbai. The first one was the slum sanitation project, which started in the late 90s, in around 1997, with the help of the World Bank funds. A great project, initially took off very well. There were some great international papers, and the World Bank itself said that it can be a model for sanitation issues around the world, similar cities around the world. So they had taken this presentation to Brazil and several other places, which could be compared demographically and with other problems related to Mumbai. And where that was the vision then. But over a period of time, it suffered very, very poorly at the hands of the politicians. And eventually, when you talk about pay-and use model, which could be a kind of a community-driven model or a out-and-out pay-and use like Sulab, the point is that when you add it all up, we are talking about a huge amount of revenue generation per day in Mumbai. And so there is some kind of a vested interest that gets weaved in as we roll it out. And that is exactly what happened to slum sanitation program. And that is exactly what happened to the Dattak Vasti Yojana, where I think about 5-6 years of implementation and it got embroiled in controversies with a lot of money embezzlement by local cooperators. And this made news, and so everyone knows about it. So which is now Swachh Mumbai Prabodhan Abhiyan. So both these programs built it in their own weight and the dirty political interference. And I'm like unlucky, we are very unlucky that most of these things we don't have the right kind of political representation at the BMC. So, but I don't know if even they would be bothered by me talking about all of this. And so as a fallout of all of this, the complete neglect of sanitation and water, I would say, in Mumbai, it has had a great impact on the overall health of the city. And I would want to point out this, this report by my colleague Rachel, which we released about a couple of years back. And it says, Mumbai's shame, how undernutrition and poor sanitation are stunting the growth of children in Mumbai's structured and unstructured slums. Now, this report actually goes on to say that the children who are not having access to closed sanitation like show very high levels, up to 69% of underweightage and up to 56% of stunting in Mumbai. We are not even talking about some small village in Bihar or someplace. We are not talking, even talking about rural Maharashtra. This is a fact that has come out in this report in Mumbai itself. And it records that it's the lack of sanitation is not a symptom of poverty, but actually a major contributing factor. आम तौर पे कहूँ कि मैं गरीब हूँ इसके लिए मुझे शौचालय मेरे घर में नहीं है ऐसा नहीं है मेरे घर में शौचालय नहीं है इसके लिए मैं गरीब हूँ और आज वो भी there are several world reports, global reports which say that every dollar of investment will eventually give rise to about 7% of GDP. So there is a direct correlation. And so what SSP and DVY, which is now DVY, the Dattak Pasti Yojana, which is now the slum, the Swachh Mumbai Prabodhan Abhiyan, unka experience hai batata hai ki participatory, they are great. If they are implemented well and if they have the longevity and the full support of the politicians. But if they are going to be usurped by the politicians themselves for their own greed, then they are going to fail or at least not achieve the required results. And so what is the ultimate solution? The ultimate solution would be individual toilets. And this is a great example. We've got some representation from this very slum in Tulshetpada. This is about, I think, 15 years ago when they had the chance to have individual toilets in their homes. And we will have some people narrate their experience as to what changes it brought in their lives. Yes, sir, these are individual toilets. And And these are very, very small slum rooms, but they all have some very nice pick and span individual toilets. So we have raised, like, you know, after this, we did two very important reports. One is called Toilet Torture. It says, Potatil Kar Shauchalayacha Chhal. And this is a Marathi version of it. In English, it's called Toilet Torture. And which was followed by a report which we did, which is yet to be published, called Jaye To Jaye Kahan. Finding answers to nature's calls in maximum city. And here it's a very comprehensive study with a lot of field visits and a lot of field data recovered. And these are some of the 10 most important demands that we make to each and every stakeholder. We are not just talking holding the BMC responsible, the state government and everybody down the line. That first, please encourage, incentivize, promote and prioritize individual toilets in slums wherever possible. We might encounter places where it's not possible, but then there is a way how to deal with them. And establish a single authority for solid waste management and sanitation. We cannot have 15 different agencies looking taking care of the same thing in Mumbai, and which has actually given rise to toilet fiefdom of elected representatives. And there are umpteen number of stories we have recorded in this large report of ours, where Mahada and the toilet construction is actually used as a very filthy money-making game by the politicians. And this goes right up to the CM's office and put an end to Mahada's rule, which contribute to more than 65% of toilets in the city, which are nothing but hellholes of squalor. And the point is that every time you talk about sanitation, it's always the BMC that is responsible. But why should it continue to face public outrage when it is only really responsible for only about 20% of the toilets in the city in the public domain? And so compulsory desludging of septic tanks and planned and time-bound lying of sewer mains. It is as important as water. Like in a city that wastes 90 million liters of water on a daily basis, 900 million liters of water on a daily basis, what can we even say about sanitation and sewerage? Eco-friendly public toilets. And I think we have an example here, a partner organization of ours, Tri Ratna Prerna Mandal. And they have done some amazing work by using the public toilet, the community toilet under SSP as a nucleus for 360 degree transformation of the entire neighborhood. And they have all three of them. They have rooftop solar, they have rainwater harvesting, and they also have an STP. Provision of sanitation blocks in the development plan. Now, which city, which development plan or which city can develop it doesn't have sanitation? There's no development without sanitation. But there is not a word, not even a word of any of the many drafts of the development plan that have come right now under controversy. PPP for public toilets, awareness and IEC. Now, this is one area where private funding, I'll take an example of the toilet just outside, just in front of the Gateway of India or right in front of the Taj. Now, why can't someone as big as the Taj Group can take over the maintenance and upkeep of that toilet? Now, I think it's just a matter. There is also one another friend of ours called Mr. Fuar Lukhandwala. He has been come under severe criticism from the BMC. But when you, as a complete outsider, look at his plan, I think it holds a lot of value. It's like, you know, in creating public toilets against advertising space of billboard space in the city, and it's a great model. And clear definition of sanitation services under the ESMA. And I think this is as important as water, and any failure to provide timely sanitation services must be considered as a kind of a penal act. And welfare of Safai Karmacharis. Nothing in India, not a single venture in terms of cleanliness and sanitation will move ahead even an inch unless we think about the welfare of Safai Karmacharis and give it the highest prominence. It is as important, and we have got Mr. Ramesh Haralkar here, jinhone apni puri zindagi Safai Karmachariyon ke uddhar ke liye laga di hai. And last but not the least, reserve land in each ward for decentralized management. So that decentralized solid waste management, I think, is an integral part of cleanliness. And unless that is done, we'll end up sending even the smallest needle that we produce as waste from our house to Devnar. And so sanitation in slums, in a nutshell, I think, is possible. And if we can all come together, the people, the government, the BMCA, the administration, and the local politicians, that the most, it is possible. And I'll end this with a very happy picture of families who have benefited and seen a lot of transformation in their lives from the last past almost 15 years now. Thank you very much.
मी माननीय दराडे मॅडमना विनंती करतो की त्यांनी आपले विचार मांडावेत.